All right, good evening, everyone. This is the June 24th, 2020 meeting of the Auburn Conservation Commission. As a preliminary matter, this is Michael Garland. I'm chair of the commission. Permit me to confirm that all members and persons anticipated on the agenda are present and can hear me. So members, when I call your name, please respond in the affirmative. Tom Fallon.
Here.
Michelle Kollross.
Here.
Carolyn Corvo.
Here.
Allison Holmes.
Here.
Nathan Rand. I don't think Nathan is with us. And then Antonio Romeo. Tony, are you there? Okay, we have a quorum. We also have town officials and employees participating. When I call your name, please respond in the affirmative. Building Commissioner Caleb Moody.
Here.
DDIS Director Darlene Coyle.
Here.
Town Planner Adam Menard.
Here.
Outstanding. Good evening, everyone. This open meeting of the Auburn Conservation Commission is now called to order at 7 p.m. This meeting is being conducted remotely, consistent with Governor Baker's executive order of March 12, 2020, due to the current state of emergency in the Commonwealth due to the outbreak of the COVID-19 virus. In order to mitigate the transmission of the virus, we have been advised and directed by the Commonwealth to suspend public gatherings. And as such, the governor's order suspends the requirement of the open meeting law to have all meetings in a publicly accessible physical location. Further, all members of public bodies are allowed and encouraged to participate remotely. The order, which you can find posted with agenda materials for this meeting on the town's website, allows public bodies to meet entirely remotely so long as reasonable public access is afforded so that the public can follow along with the deliberations of the meeting. For this meeting, the Conservation Commission is convening by remote participation for the public only, although some staff may be physically located in the Selectmen's meeting in Town Hall or somewhere else. Those town employees are practicing social distancing in accordance with the governor's orders. For the public to join the meeting remotely by telephone, call 1-408-650-3123 and enter the access code 942-845-549. Or the public can join via computer at gotomeeting.com/join/942-845-549. The remote access information has been posted on the town's website identifying how the public may join. Please also note that this meeting is being recorded by Auburn Cable Television for your viewing pleasure later on. Accordingly, those members of the Conservation Commission, employees, and members of the public who participate, please be aware that other folks may be able to see you, and please take care not to screen share your computer. Anything that you broadcast may be captured by the recording. All supporting materials that have been provided to members of this body are available on the town's website. The public is encouraged to follow along using the posted agenda. Now, with regard to the meeting rules, we will now be turning to the first item on our agenda. Before we do so, permit me to cover some ground rules for effective and clear conduct of our business and to ensure accurate meeting minutes. I, as chairman of the commission, will introduce each speaker on the agenda. After they conclude their remarks, the chair will go down the line of members, inviting each by name to provide any comment, questions, or motions, or I may just throw it out there. Please hold until your name is called. Please remember to speak clearly and in a way that helps generate accurate minutes. For any response, please wait until the chair yields the floor to you and state your name before speaking. If members wish to engage in discussion with other members, please do so through the chair, taking care to identify yourself. So after the members of the commission have spoken, the chair will afford public comment as follows. I will first ask members of the public who wish to speak to identify themselves by their names and addresses only. And once the chair has a list of all public commentators, I will call on each by name and afford 3 minutes for any comments. Finally, each vote taken in this meeting will be conducted by a roll call vote. Just as a note, if any technical difficulties arise, I will suspend the meeting while attempts to resolve are made. Hopefully that will not be a problem. In any event, we're gonna proceed. So the first item on tonight's agenda is a 7 o'clock public hearing. A notice of intent filed for the Auburn Water District for the proposed interconnection with the City of Worcester at South Bridge and Sword Streets. Is there a motion to open?
So moved.
And that was Tom Fallon. Is there a second?
Michelle, second it.
Okay, so I'm going to give it to Michelle because she beat. Was that you, Carolyn?
Yes, that's okay. She said her name first. No problem.
Okay, so it's going to be first come, first serve. So Michelle Kohlruss is seconded.
Absolutely.
Is there any discussion? All those in favor? Aye.
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 Opposed? It's a vote. All right, who is here on behalf of the Auburn Warren District? Please state your name.
My name is Ken Smith, Water Superintendent from the Auburn Water District.
And David Roman from CEI is also here representing Auburn Water District.
All right, gentlemen, good evening. So members of the commission had an opportunity to go out to the site and the site of work with Mr. Smith this past Saturday. And of those who attended, Mr. Smith was very helpful in terms of showing us the scope of work, where the work was being conducted, the unique challenges that are afforded by the site where the water connection is being proposed. So Mr. Roman, I know you had a conflict and couldn't be there. Is there anything you want to add to basically to what has been submitted to the commission?
No, I don't think so. I had a chance to talk with Ken, and it sounds like, you know, when you guys were doing everything on Saturday.
Okay.
Nothing to add. Thank you.
Ken, do you have any further comments?
No, just if any, through the chair, if anybody who wasn't in attendance has any questions, I'd be willing to offer or clarify anything.
Okay, very good. Do you have any questions, Tom? Okay. Does any other members who are accessing this meeting remotely have any questions for Mr. Smith or Mr. Roman regarding the project?
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
Mark Galal, 4 Field Street, town meeting member,
sir,
precinct 4.
Sir, hold on, sir. So respectfully, sir, that was for members of the commission. So let me go through.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. We'll go through the members of the commission first, sir, and then we'll give you your time, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right. Do any members of the commission have any questions for Mr. Smith or Mr. Roman concerning the project?
Yes, this is Carolyn Corvo, to the chair, please.
Sure.
Mr. Smith, this connection would be a continual, would mix with all of the water wells that we have in town of the Auburn Water District. In other words, this connection will be in continual movement with all of that well water. Is that correct?
No, that is not correct.
Okay.
This is being proposed as a supplemental source of a reliable supplemental source of water. Should our existing 12 wells become incapacitated due to contamination or unanticipated mechanical breakdown, or as you look outside today, if we get into a more serious drought condition and we can't keep up with it, even with water restrictions, it is not our intention to use this full time. For one obvious reason, is the cost of water. But we will use it as a supplemental source.
And would the public, would those who are participants or who have Auburn Water District to use that, would they be informed when this does happen or could happen?
We didn't anticipate that because it could come on, you know, in an emerging situation, not, you know, planned. It was not our intention to do so. It's going to mix with all, right now it'll mix with water from about half of our wells into our low pressure system. We have two pressure systems, high and low. This will mix with the low pressure system.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Smith.
Okay.
All set.
Any other comments from the board? So, Mr. Smith, just I want to revisit one of the topics we discussed on Saturday. Apparently, while you're ready to go, there is an issue of funding, correct?
That's correct.
And so at this point, you don't have a source of funding, so that right now, assuming the project is approved, you still won't be able to proceed until you can identify a funding source. Is that fair?
That's We'd rather be shovel ready and seek funding than be the other way around.
I understand. Okay, thank you.
You know, we can't anticipate where funding may came from. We're investigating the number of sources as mentioned on Saturday.
Okay, great. Now, I understand that there are there any members of the public that wish to ask Mr. Smith or anyone for that matter questions about this project?
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Yes, sir.
Mark Renoff, 4 Field Street, town meeting member, precinct 4. This project's in my precinct I represent. Are they going to be doing all that work at nighttime? And when they do the hookups, will they be shutting off the water if they are to let the residents and the businesses in the area know when they shut the water off? Give them a little notice so they can plan.
But Dave, if you want, I'll handle this one. Sir, this project will be, we will be connecting to a dead end main from the city of Worcester. Connect to that, and they would probably be doing the work, hopefully a minimal traffic interruption according to with our Massachusetts DOT road opening permit. I don't anticipate it to be done at night, be done during the day. And there should be no significant water interruption. The only water interruption would be maybe short term, a few hours to the water main that's in Sword Street, the dead end main. Other than that, there really shouldn't be any interruption of service. Mr. Chair, is Mr. Dave Roman has any comment on this?
Sure.
Ken, that is absolutely right. And, you know, there will be a temporary water line on Sword Street, but that is it.
So it wouldn't affect Packetchog Hill at all then?
No, Packetchog Hill, are you served by Elm Hill Water District, sir?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, we're not touching the Elm Hill at all. They're aware of the project. Met with them probably 9 months ago to discuss it. They're aware of it, and there should be no interruption of planned service to the Elm Hill Water District.
And how many feet from the road is there, that building you're putting in for, like, the metering?
It's Dave?
Yeah, the road, it's approximately 15 feet off of the road.
So it's not going to interfere with the sidewalk or the parking, the road there?
It will not.
Okay,
the sidewalk will stay intact.
Okay, during the construction?
The sidewalk is on the east side, isn't it?
Yeah, but isn't there a little sidewalk in that area?
It's a gravel area mostly used by the railroad people to park there.
Okay, I know what you're saying. Okay. Okay, well, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Sure.
Are there any other questions from the public concerning this project? Any follow-up questions from members of the board? There being none, is there a motion to close?
I make a motion that we close the hearing of the notice of intent in the Auburn Water District, the proposed interconnection with the city of Worcester.
Okay, is there a second?
Michelle Colaras, I'll second that.
All right, is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? It's a vote. All right. Mr. Smith and Mr. Roman, thank you very much for participating tonight. Hopefully we will have the opportunity to issue our decision after the public hearings are concluded.
We appreciate the opportunity to meet with the board and to discuss this important project. And should any members have any questions, they can reach out to me and we'll get the answers to them.
Terrific. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Have a good evening.
You too.
Bye-bye.
All right. The next item on our agenda is a 7:15 public hearing. Mike Pham, it's a notice of intent for the proposed construction of a single-family home with a driveway and septic system at 90 Tinker Hill Road. Is there a motion to open?
Motion to open.
Is there a
So moved.
That was Tom Fallon. Is there a second?
Carolyn Corvo, I'll second it.
All right. Is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? It's a vote. All right. Is there anyone here for Mr. Pham or for the applicant for 90 Tinker Hill Road? Well, in that case, several members of the commission had the opportunity to walk the site last Saturday. We met with the builder, with Mr. Pham, and I think his well and consultant. And I think at Allison Holmes' request, the proposed construction was moved out of the 25-foot no-build zone. I think the previous plan showed some slight encroachment, but at Allison's request specifically, the building was moved to take it out of the zone. And in fact, the applicant submitted a revised plan on June 17th. And I think members have copies, and I think it should be available on the website as well. If there's no one representing the applicant, are there any questions from members of the board concerning the plan or the project? So, Allison, did I fairly summarize what you had requested?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Are there any questions from members of the public? In that case, if there are none, and if there's no further discussion, is there a motion to close?
Make a motion, we close the public hearing. Tom?
Is there a second?
Michelle Kollross, I'll second it.
All right, is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
It's a vote. Okay. We have about 12 minutes before the next public hearing at 7:30. Did members of the commission have an opportunity to look at the meeting minutes?
Yes.
So did I.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Carolyn.
Does anyone, let's take them one at a time. The meeting minutes for March 11, 2020. Any changes?
March 11. I didn't see any. Michelle Kollross.
Okay.
No.
Carolyn, you're good?
No.
Allison, did you have two?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm fine.
Okay. In that case, is there a motion to approve the meeting minutes for March 11, 2020?
I make a motion that we approve the minutes of the meeting on March 11th on today, which is 6:24.
Okay. Is there a second?
Michelle Collins, I'll second that.
All right. Is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay. Actually, Michelle, you can't.
I was just going to say, wait a minute, I can't.
I can't,
sorry.
Okay, so let's back up that. All right. So Carolyn made the motion to approve the meeting minutes of March 11, 2020. Is there a second?
I'll second that. This is Allison.
Okay, good. Is there any discussion?
Thank you.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Abstain?
Michelle. Aye, Michelle.
Okay, Michelle abstains. Very good. Okay. So, Michelle, which trip were you on that time?
I can't remember.
Okay.
Go on another one, let me tell you.
I'm sure that's true. All
yeah.
Right. The next meeting minutes are for April 22nd of 2020.
Okay.
And I want to give kudos to Ginger. You're doing an excellent job. It's been kind of a running joke in the commission for several years that there were certain individuals on the board. Bill Loosemore comes to mind, and also Mr. Reich, Dan Reich, who would, frankly, nitpick. the meeting minutes, but Ginger, I think, did an excellent job in doing them. So I reviewed these meeting minutes, and I did not have any changes to make.
This is Ginger. I would like to take credit for it, but I actually have not been doing the minutes. Shannon has been doing them.
Who is Shannon?
Shannon.
She deserves a gold star.
Please
give her my.
Oh yeah, her name's on the. Yeah. Her name's on the back.
Is it?
Shannon.
Shannon Regan. Well, hats off to Shannon Regan. Thank you, Shannon. All right. getting back to business if you can. Does anyone have any changes for the meeting minutes of April 22nd?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right.
Carolyn, no.
Tom, anything?
Nope.
All right, in that case, is there a motion?
Make a motion, we accept the meeting minutes of Wednesday, April 22nd, 2020.
All right, is there a second?
I will second. Carolyn, I'll second. Go.
We need a tie break here. I'm going to give it to Carolyn.
All right. Okay, no problem. No problem.
All right. Is there any discussion?
Thank you.
All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay, opposed?
Good.
It's a vote. All right. And last but not least, the meeting minutes for May 13th of 2020. I also reviewed these, and I did not have any time to make.
Well, I don't see anything either. Carolyn, I don't see anything. I'm all set.
God, we're going to get spoiled here. In that case, is there a motion?
This is Carolyn. I make a motion that we accept the minutes of the May 13th virtual meeting of the Conservation Commission as is.
All right. Is there a second?
I can't.
That's true. You can't. Go ahead, Tom.
I'll second that.
All right.
Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
All right. is there any discussion?
We're good.
All those in favor? Aye.
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 Okay. Opposed?
Aye.
Abstentions?
I abstain.
Okay. It's a vote. All right, everyone. Thank you.
We're good.
And we still have a few minutes or some time. Okay. So,
on the business.
Excuse me, Mike.
Yes.
Who was the abstention?
The abstention was Michelle Colross. So, let me report to the board. We received a complaint some time ago, as you will recall, of a line running from 341 Leicester Street to. A pond located at 343 Leicester Street. I had gone out to the site, I had taken some pictures, and so I was actually able to determine the names of the property owners at 341 Leicester Street. I will send out a letter. And Ginger, so what I'll do, Ginger, is I'll prepare the letter and I will send it to you tomorrow for, and also circulate it among the members of the commission. Basically, I think as we had discussed, we felt that the property owner needed to come in and explain what the purpose was for the line and why they put it in and why they didn't notify anyone before they did that. So you can anticipate getting a draft of that letter sometime tomorrow.
Okay.
All right. Yep, I still have 6 minutes.
Good. Good. Other business? Nice.
Town planner. From what I understand, there was brought up at the last meeting, there were some questions about the town's municipal vulnerability preparedness program and the status of the grants that we have going on.
Yes.
I'll just give you a brief history for those not familiar with the program. As part of Governor Baker's environmental bond bill several years ago, the environmental preparedness program was created to address climate change. About a year and a half ago, the town was awarded a grant to conduct a municipal vulnerability preparedness workshop. The workshop was done about a year ago. I think it was last spring it was completed. The town was certified as an MVP community. And this certification allowed the town to pursue MVP action grants. So the town was fortunate enough in January to be awarded the action grant. The grant was twofold. The first was to address the drinking water supply areas and to develop a report of the best practices to protect the drinking water supply. The town partnered with the Auburn Water District, since the district supplies water to about 80% of the town. The town does rely on the water's district. So there was a report that was completed, a draft report that was completed about a month ago that is currently on the town's webpage and social media. It's out there for public comment. It's quite the in-depth analysis. Fussin O'Neill was the engineering firm the town consulted with to create this report. They did a quantitative study of all the outfall areas in town, determined mainly which roadways were contaminating the wells the most. And it's not overly surprising, it was mainly the highways, Route 12, Route 20, the heavily trafficked roads, a lot of salt, a lot of oils and other contaminants can pollute the wells. So we've developed the best management report. Again, that's out there, public comment. Anyone wants the commission to take a look at it, it's on the website, or I'm happy to email it to the town. The other part of that grant was to develop a green bridge concept to hopefully eventually replace the failing culverts at Sword Street that the Kettlebrook flows underneath. Those culverts are in rough shape, to say the least. They've been failing for some time, and the town's been trying to seek funding to replace those. So we're working with Fussin O'Neill to develop some creative ways to probably replace it with a bridge. Is the intent, I think, at this point. We just had a meeting this afternoon. The span of the bridge would be about 72 feet, so it will be a fairly lengthy bridge. We're looking at some ideas of where to source materials, locally sourced materials. There's one idea of building the bridge out of recycled toilets. Just kind of unique green concepts. One idea was to have a historical sign talking about the Worcester Diversion Channel, which is kind of a unique feature in that area. Mm-hmm. So we're having internal discussions about just some of the thoughts about what we'd like to see as a replacement for that bridge. And the town last week submitted another grant application for the new round that was hopefully we'll have it the state will announce grant awards over the summer. But the town put a request in to continue the work on replacing the green bridge, namely to do the environmental work and engineering study. Specifically the wetland delineation, which will continue some of the work that was done this past spring. Geotechnical investigations, stream substrate study, hydrological and hydraulic calculations, geotechnical evaluations, generally all the preliminary engineering aspects to building eventually the bridge. So that was submitted to the state last week. There's another part of that grant we're hoping to get that will include an education outreach to the residents of the Leesville Pond area. That pond has some pollution issues. There are high phosphorus and E. coli counts in that pond. So we're hoping that we receive the funds to do education for both the Auburn and Worcester residents. The intent is to kind of draw a circle half a mile in diameter around the pond and encompass all residents and business owners and other property owners, invite them to an event and the public in general to an event to kind of just provide some education on how they can help better protect the drinking, the water in that area, stormwater, and make it better for everybody, because that is the main source of the Blackstone River, which affects numerous communities all the way down to Providence.
Right, exactly.
So hopefully we receive that grant, and hopefully we'll know sometime this summer if we receive that or not.
That's excellent.
So if anybody, if the commission has any questions, I'm happy to answer. Okay. They'll be public outreach going forward.
But the study is available on the town website.
Yes.
Terrific. We'll make sure we take a look at it.
Great, thank you.
All right, thank you. Okay. It now being 7:30, the next item on our agenda is a 7:30 public hearing, Eastland Partners, Inc., a notice of intent for the proposed construction of a two-family structure with decks and installation of utilities to service to a service structure and associated grading within the 100 buffers foot zone at 31 and 33 Albert Street in Auburn. Is there a motion to open?
Tom, so moved.
Is there a second?
Carolyn, I'll second it.
Okay. Is there any discussion? All those in favor? Aye?
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
Opposed? It's a vote.
Aye.
Okay. Is anyone here on behalf of Eastland Partners?
Good evening, Mr. Chairman. My name is Steve O'Connell from Turning Point Engineering on behalf of Eastland Partners.
Hi, Mr. O'Connell. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you.
Very good. So, we apparently passed like ships in the night on Saturday, and I apologize for that. Members of the board did go out to Albert Street at about 9:30 or so, and for whatever reason, there was a mix-up in the time. I understand that you were there at 10:30, so I apologize for that. We did walk the site. We walked the cul-de-sac, and I think other members of the commission will agree that what was submitted to us and what is shown on the plan that you submitted appear to be different. And so I'm hoping that you can explain the erosion control measures that we saw in place appear to be much closer to the cul-de-sac than what is proposed for your project at Albert Street. Is that fair?
Yes, absolutely. It's correct, Mr. Chairman. A little bit of background I can provide you and the commission members that could shed some light on the situation is that this is an active under-construction subdivision that is being built according to approved subdivision plans from the planning board and also an order of conditions by your commission. So the erosion control measures that you see in place today and when you're during your visit on Saturday represent erosion control measures associated with the construction of just the subdivision roadway and associated infrastructure. The subdivision was a five-lot subdivision, and this is the only lot, the application we've submitted is the only lot that proposes work in the buffer zone, on an individual lot basis, which is necessitated an individual notice of intent separate from the subdivision notice of intent.
Okay.
Unfortunately, we did not connect on Saturday, but if we could have, we were prepared to show you the extent of the limit of disturbance on site, the proposed, which is also coterminous with the proposed erosion control barrier you see on the plan. We'd also staked out the four corners of the proposed dwelling structure, and I could have pointed out a number of other things, including the wetland delineation flags, mm-hmm. and the condition of the site itself. Not sure what else the members of the site walk observed, but it's a relatively straightforward application, in my opinion. It's a duplex home, single lot. All work is proposed outside of the 50-foot buffer zone. Roof runoff will be directed to underground recharge units. The other aspects of the runoff from the development are conveyed to a stormwater basin system, which has been reviewed and approved by the planning board's consulting engineer, Graves Engineering. In fact, the planning board approved a minor modification last night to some of those stormwater changes that are actually constructed on site. There's erosion control measures proposed to the extent even beyond, you know, many customary measures. For example, this has a crushed stone construction entrance at the location of the proposed driveway so that construction vehicles do not track dirt and mud onto the recently paved cul-de-sac of the subdivision road named Albert Street. And that may be confusing too, the name, the fact that it's Albert Street, because when you drive the Albert Street that everyone in Auburn has known for a long time, which comes off Route 20, was extended by the subdivision crossing over Blaker and terminating in this cul-de-sac that you walked around in on Saturday.
Right.
The duplex will be serviced by town water and town sewer. It received site plan approval from the planning board recently and also a special permit from the zoning board for the proposed duplex. We just have this commission's permitting steps to finalize everything we need.
So if you look at the erosion control measures that are in place currently, how far beyond that silt fence is the erosion control that is shown in your plan?
Well, let me put it this way. The erosion control that you see now on site mm-hmm. outside of the cul-de-sac is probably about 12 feet off the pavement. Does that sound accurate from your observations?
Yeah, actually, it does. It was pretty close to the cul-de-sac.
Yep. But so, like I said, that's just to contain the sediment that could run off during construction of the cul-de-sac. So, you know, this lot goes quite a ways beyond that silt fence off the cul-de-sac. So we're talking about distances of about probably 80 to 100 feet, depending on where you measure it from.
Right, and it hasn't been cleared yet.
No, it has not. I'm not sure if you walked into the proposed lot area, but it's very thin. You know, there's mature trees. But because this property before it was a subdivision was the backyard, two houses were purchased and demolished as part of the development of this property. And I would say that the prior owner of the property probably did some firewood cutting, which is pretty customary for people who burn wood. So this area happens to already be thinned, but it's very stabilized. There's a forest matting of forest debris on the ground, but it's not as dense as some forested areas that I'm sure you see on regular site walks. But it is not cleared. It has been preserved in its condition since Eastland Partners acquired it, and relatively flat. It will just be a 3-to-1 slope at the rear of the lot upon completion of the lot development outside of the 50-foot buffer zone.
All right. Tom, do you have any questions?
No questions.
Are there any questions from members of the board? Any questions from members of the board? That was Michelle.
No, Carolyn.
Oh, Carolyn, thank you. Michelle, any questions?
No.
Okay, Allison?
No.
All right. Well, if that is the case, is there a motion to close?
Mr. Chairman, may I comment on something? This is Steve O'Connell.
Oh, yeah, go ahead, Steve.
I'm sorry. Everything I do, I try to be completely transparent on what I wanted to, what I had hoped to review with the commission members at the site walk on Saturday was updated wetland delineation. Mm-hmm. And I'd be remiss if I allowed you to close the hearing without discussing that. So mm-hmm. as part of preparation for the site walk, we had refreshed wetland flags.
Right.
In that whole exercise, We found out that the wetland flag numbers shown on the plan that was submitted and you have on the screen now are old, incorrect wetland flag numbers.
Okay.
So I want to make sure that the plan that would hopefully be approved represents the flag numbers. So during the time period for which the permit is active and construction would be occurring, that the plan is accurate, and if any inspections were to occur, it was very clear. Everything's on the up and up. So I just wanted to let you know that at your discretion, we would like to submit a plan showing the corrected wetland flag numbers.
Well, I think we would like that, as a matter of fact. Do you have any idea?
I hope so.
Do you have any idea why the incorrect flag numbers are shown on the plan that was submitted back in May?
Well, I do. That was prepared by Guerrier and Hellman. They were an engineering firm who prepared the subdivision plans for Eastland Partners.
Okay.
The gentleman who represented us at the last meeting, Peter Lavoie, it's kind of a long story. I'll give you the short version. He was an employee of Guerrier and Hellman. He came to work for Turning Point representing Eastland Partners. And I think it was really just a mistake on his part taking incorrect information from his files from Guerrier and Hellman when he prepared the Turning Point plan.
Okay. And
I missed it. As a supervisor, I missed it in my review of the plan before it was submitted. But during the preparation of the site visit, we caught it. And I just wanted to, be upfront about that and let you know we're ready to submit a revised plan showing the correct flagging. But I figured I would wait to see if there's any other comments that needed to be shown on a revised plan before doing that.
When was the wetland flagged? Do you recall?
It was, as part of the process, we had the wetland verified. So you could say that it was as recent as last week because the wetland scientist from BNC Associates, he validated the wetland flags that we refreshed. And he's prepared me an updated memorandum stating that. So they are very recent wetland flags of last week.
Can you submit that to us, please?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
I'll submit that with a revised plan.
So let me discuss this with members of the board. So we have the option of closing the public hearing. We are going to be meeting within 21 days. Our next meeting, I believe, is July 8th. And so we have the option of either closing the public hearing but not issuing an order pending receipt of the memorandum regarding the wetland confirmation and the revised plan, or we can continue it to the July 8th meeting. I'm just asking members of the board what their preference is. Tom, do you have a preference?
No, I concur. I think it's a good idea to have a resubmit the plan. Unless we resubmit the plan, we can.
Okay.
Yep.
So, Mr. O'Connell, do you understand what I'm saying?
I do.
Okay.
Yep.
What we would do is we would close the public hearing, but we would not render a decision until we received the memorandum regarding the well delineation and the revised plan.
Understood.
Okay. Do members of the board feel about that? Carolyn?
This is Carolyn. Yes, thank you. I agree with Tom and you. I believe that we should receive a revised plan first.
Okay. Michelle?
I'm torn. Are the flags that different? Are they in that different of a space, or are they just different numbers?
There are some variations. None of the wetland flags on the revised plan that we'll submit are closer to the proposed work. In fact, they're the ones that are probably closest to the work are actually further away. So we'll actually be providing more separation from the wetland.
Okay, so the well in line has changed then?
Yeah, it changed a little bit.
Okay.
Then we need a new plan.
Okay. All right.
Yep. I definitely want to give you a new plan. I'm happy to continue.
All right.
I'm not pressuring you at all to take action prematurely. We got a little bit of time before we'd be seeking a building permit on this lot, or Eastland would be. So I just, I want to give you all the opportunity to review, the latest plan.
Okay.
This would have been much easier in person on Saturday. That was, so unfortunately that mix-up happened, but it sounds like, we're communicating okay about it.
Allison,
all right.
What are your thoughts, Allison?
My thoughts is that, based on the confusion with the erosion control and not really knowing what we were looking at with the plan, I would like to actually review the wetland flags. I don't think we got that far. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if it's possible to do another site walk, at least for myself, if anyone wants to join me. So my vote would be to continue if that's all right with them time-wise.
I mean, I think as a practical matter, since we're not going to be able to issue an order until July 8th anyway, I think it makes sense. Get the revised plan, take the revised plan and compare it to the well and flags the way they have been posted in on the property. And then at that point, there's absolutely no misunderstanding.
Exactly.
So I actually agree with you, Allison. So, and Mr. O'Connell, that's agreeable to you?
Yes, absolutely. I think it's like, it sounds like you're also agreeable to a follow-up site walk for the members that are interested in doing so, and I'm also in agreement for that.
Okay, perfect then. So, in that case, is there a motion to continue the public hearing in this matter to July 8th?
I'd just like to make one more comment.
Sure,
chair.
Please.
Looking at the calendar, I know that 4th of July is on a Saturday, so if we're going to do it, we probably need to do it this Saturday if we're going to do it on a weekend day.
I know, I have a conflict this Saturday, but I think, that doesn't bar anyone else from going out.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Yeah, this Saturday works for me, if that works for you, Stephen.
It does.
This Saturday works for me as well. This is Michelle.
All right, so... And just so we're crystal clear, what would be a good time for everyone to meet at the site? Mr. O'Connell?
I'm flexible. I'm a morning person, so I'm happy to do it as early as anyone would like, but I'm also available, throughout the day.
So say like 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, seriously, with the heat, maybe that would be a good idea.
How about 9 o'clock?
No.
Nine o'clock
works better for me. 5:30 doesn't happen in my world, so no.
Thanks for sharing.
Welcome to my world.
All right, in that case, is there a motion to continue the public hearing in this matter to July 8th?
7 p.m.
At 7 p.m.
I'll make that motion. This is Allison.
Okay, is there a second?
I'll second that. This is Carolyn.
Okay, discussion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, it's a vote. So, Mr. O'Connell, several of us will be meeting with you this Saturday at 9 a.m.
Sounds great. If I could just take an opportunity to let you know that I'll be there ahead of time. I'll have the gate open so you can drive right up to the cul-de-sac.
Perfect. Very good.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, good, thank you. All right, where's my chair? All right, so the only thing that we have left is to the orders for the Urban Water District and also for 90 Tinkerhill Road. So who wants to be the brave soul to take a crack at these? Tom.
Yeah. Tom does.
Well, I volunteer, Tom, but he's...
I'm ready. All right, so...
All right, for the Urban Water District, is there a motion?
I'm making a motion that we issue for the Urban Water District a standard order plus special conditions number 1, 2, 3, 5... 8,
Put in 9.
Yeah. 9. 11.
I don't think there's any detention.
No.
Okay. So, standard order plus 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 9, 11, and 11. Okay. Is there a second?
This is Carolyn. I'll second that.
All right. Is there any discussion?
This is Allison. Is there any special conditions we should add about, you know, the areas right around the pond, like blown filter socks or something like that to get a real good protection over there? That was my only thought.
I mean, they're gonna use best
practices. Versus hay bales.
Block what logs, whatever, like.
I mean, we can insist they use best management practices for erosion control.
Okay, that's all. All
right.
That works.
All right, so in that case, then, why don't we, if you take 5, I would amend special condition 5 as follows. Erosion and settlement control measures will comply with best management practices and be placed between the work area and the edge of the BVW. Okay, is there a second to Tom's motion? I think, Carolyn, you seconded, correct?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did, Mike.
Okay, as amended. Is there any discussion?
As amended.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye?
Aye.
Opposed? All right, it's a vote. And then for 90 Tinker Hill Road, is there a motion?
Tom, for 90 Tinker Hill Road, I make a motion to issue standard order. Plus numbers 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 9, 11, 12. I think that's it.
Yeah, there's no detention shown or anything. Okay, so standard order plus 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 9, 11, and 12. Is there a second?
Michelle Collins, I'll second that.
Okay. Is there any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? All right, it's a vote. And then just finally, we have received an email. I think it actually went to Caleb back in June 2nd. And this was an email that was sent, all right, actually it was sent to the Conservation Commission, so I apologize, but it was sent by Julie Carlson from Four Brotherton Way. And she had some concerns or questions about the trails around Dark Brook and how apparently it's being used for recreational biking, causing damage to the area. And so the question is there anything that we can do to make that portion of the trail for foot traffic only? And I think it's an excellent idea. I don't have an answer, but I think it's an excellent idea. I mean, I suppose those trails are owned by the town, aren't they? Do we know?
I don't know who owns okay. Probably maybe Albert Water District.
Yeah, probably.
Okay, so
I think it's Albert Water District.
So, all right. Who was that?
That was Michelle.
Okay, Michelle. So if that's the case, then maybe we can reach out to Ken Smith and perhaps they can put up some signage. I mean, the problem is, and we had this issue with Packachog, as you will recall, there would be a lot of four-wheelers and dirt bikes and that sort of thing, and they could create a mess. And it's just, it's really a question of enforcement. But perhaps if signs could be posted, that might be one way to minimize that sort of disruption. So what I'll do is I
we could also...
Go ahead.
Sorry.
That's all right.
So we could put some sort of blockage, like a concrete block or something that would prevent larger vehicles or ATVs or stuff.
Just, you know, make sure it's well lit because you don't want to hit that at night.
True.
But in any event, what I'll do is I will actually reach out to Ken Smith and ask him if he has any suggestions that might, you know, make that those trails maybe more user-friendly and might dissuade people from motorsports.
I didn't know there were trails around Dark Brook. That would be cool. I'd like to check that out.
Yeah.
Me
neither, you know, but apparently there are.
We'll have to figure out where they are so we can do the signage.
It's less expensive.
Yeah.
In the area of the dam.
Okay. Are there any other issues?
Chair, I got one thing I'd like to bring up.
Yes, please, Mr. Bernard. Come on up.
This is Adam Bernard again. The town has an open space and recreation plan that will be expiring in November 2021. It's going to need to be updated. I'm going to be forming a committee. Julie Jacob, the town manager, is going to be appointing the committee to start meeting this fall. I want to offer this commission one of the seats, if anyone in the commission would like to participate. I'm offering, this will be a five-member committee. First options are for representatives from conservation. We've offered a seat to the planning board and a seat to the board of selectmen. And there'll also be some at-large seats. So I want to let the commission know. You don't have to let me know now. I don't want us to make a decision tonight, but if you'd like to someone from this commission represent at this develop this plan. It's an important plan. It'll kind of provide guidance to how the town wants to proceed over the next 5 to 7 years for protecting the open space and the recreation avenues, like the trails you just mentioned. And it will provide the town opportunities to pursue various grants. It's a good plan to have in place.
I think it, you know. Well, thank you for the offer, and I'm pretty sure that one of us would be happy to serve. So we'll get back to you on that. But thanks. Okay.
Thank you.
I have a quick question for you, Adam.
Sure.
Does the town of Auburn have any places for ATVs? I don't think so, right? Well, I know most towns because of liability.
Yeah, I don't believe
it's
so.
Kind of like, I know they've got some commercial places like out in Brookfield and stuff like that.
And not that I'm aware of.
Yeah, I know that most towns it's just bad.
Yeah, there's a liability.
A lot of different things, yeah, liability and the erosion and stuff.
Right, yeah.
Any other matters?
Can you just update us on that 404 Leicester Street?
The update is that I haven't been able to get out there, so mea culpa, you know. I will, but I do want to go out there and speak to Mr. Ethier, so I will get to it. And I will report to the commission at our next meeting.
Perfect.
All right, thank you. And Ms. Coyle, do you have something?
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Sure.
So I just wanted to update the board regarding the electronic DEP online filing system.
Yes.
Caleb and myself have been looking at ways to make some of the work that we do administratively for the commission a little bit more efficient, and DEP has really kind of opened up a lot of areas that we can do some electronic applications and filings, and some of the orders can be prepared electronically.
Mm-hmm.
Ginger has participated in some online training, which was very positive. And she's given us some an overview of some of the things that we might be able to implement. So I just wanted to let you know that we're going to be looking into that and implementing some operational administrative work that we hope to improve.
Very good. Anything
I'm right here.
Oh,
this is Ginger.
Hi, Ginger.
Hi. I also wanted to let the board know that when I worked in Holland for the Conservation Commission, I filed all of the order of conditions through EDEP. So I do have that experience working with the online filing.
Fabulous.
Great. It'll make it a lot quicker.
I'm sure.
So, because once I fill it out and get the approval from the board, I can submit it to DEP right away. They don't have to wait for it to get go through the mail.
Okay, great.
Right. Good.
I just wanted to share the good news with you.
All right, well, thank you.
Thank you.
That's nice.
Anything else? If there are no other matters, is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Carol, I'll second it.
Okay. All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? All right, it's a unanimous vote. Thank you, everyone. Have a happy and safe 4th of July, and we'll see you on July 8th. And some of you will see each other this weekend.